CJ started a lot of games in college. I don't think it's too big for him. I think he's used to having it, and I think he's just going to go about it like he's gone about every other day throughout his career.
Positive vibes in the locker room. Seems like the guys are behind him in that regard.
Yeah, I mean, I think our guys are pros, and the guys are going to go out and do their job regardless of who's in there. And I think the guys have a lot of trust in him. I think the guys like him as a person, so it's been all positive.
Does he have an intangible quality that helps him be successful?
I mean, I think everyone who's, especially quarterbacks who are successful, has something besides just talent. And I think you got to have the ability to throw in this league to make it, and not many people do at this level. But it's the other intangibles that separate everyone: who can handle the pressure, who can do it week in and week out, who can handle the highs and lows, and recover through adversity and things like that. And I think he's shown that throughout college, and just being around the guy, I think he's a very tough person, both physically and mentally. So that's what makes him, his biggest strengths.
With a rookie making it his first start, do you pare down things offensively in the game plan, or do you throw as much at him to, just to see what he's got?
Yeah, I mean, there's no exact absolute on how to handle it. You try to make it, your whole game plan is based off what gives this guy the best chance to be successful and the 10 guys around him. So being confident, being clear-minded, being able to be aggressive and make quick reactions, that's usually what does it. When you put too much in, that can slow a guy down, make him think too much. So I definitely don't want to do that to him. But you also want to put enough in to help people get open and help them have some good opportunities, and not to where everything has to be so tough. So there's a balance in both. I think CJ can handle a lot, and we'll work on that together as this goes.
The Warriors' game plan is as classic for him. And will this week's be more tailored to your preferences, plays that you like?
Yeah, I think so. I think so, Lil. I think that was geared towards Brian, what he does. But coaches do a great job of putting together a game plan that gives us the best chance to win games. And so whether that's for me or any other quarterback, we're just trying to do what's best for us and give us the best chance, and whatever play calls those are, that's what I'll go with.
How much can a full week of preparation as a starter help?
I think it helps a lot, getting those extra reps, reps with guys that you don't usually throw to, in the huddle with the guys that are out there. I think it'll help a lot.
So, dude, what's your intangible quality to be successful as a quarterback?
I don't know. I just think I don't get too high or too low in any situation. I try to stay, pretty in my low, because I know the game of football, there's a lot of ups and downs, and you don't want to get too mad when you have a bad play, or too high when you have a good one. It's all about staying mellow and staying the same.
When a team makes a change like it made mid-season, mm-hmm. Have you processed yet what this can mean to your future and to your career, how you perform the rest of the year?
No, I'm really just trying to take it one day, one week at a time. I'm not looking that far ahead. Right now, my focus is on today's practice, and geared towards beating the Cowboys and doing the best we can to get better and improve.